Namaste, ladies and gentlemen, aspiring dancers, scholars, musicologists, medical practitioners, scientists in their respective domains. Let's try understanding Om, which is a normal practice as per Vedas and Upanishads, and it happens in whenever there is some ritual, whenever we start some kind of shloka, or whenever we start some kind of recitation, we talk about Om and we chant Om. Om, Om, Gananam Tva, Om. What is it that really, why do we need to use Om? Most of us think that Om is just used for chanting and it's used when Vedas and Upanishads or Homas or Yajnas or whatever it is. That's when. Don't you think that it has a practical importance of the yoga or the meditation? And let's try the key point or the key, the pointers or the takeaways from this video for the individuals, aspiring dancers, scholars, and teachers, gurus, medical practitioners, and scientists in their respective domains. Is understanding Om and Omkara Tattva, which is culmination of 36 tattvas of Ishvara Srishti again. And this forms a part of Yoga or Yoga Maya. And this forms a part of Maya and understanding the Maya and Mahamaya Tattva and Nirakara Swarupa, Nirakara Rupa or the Akara Rupa as well. However, it is again an open-ended question and open-ended debate for the scholars in the fine arts and culture and the classical dance form or the dansos or teachers or gurus or someone who is having experience at various levels who are practicing dance for 20 plus years or 30 plus years or 4 decades or 3 decades. One may argue Om is just a word that we do it as a part of auspicious thing. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, Om has akara, akara, ukara, makara. Akara is a face which has the human being or the human existence as such coming on to the universe, coming on to the earthly being and creating that environment and understanding that. It's a basic understanding of the genealogy or the practical application or the practical understanding of the universe. You are trying to imbibe or inscribe that knowledge first, trying to understand, which is what happens in Akara. A, U, Ukara. Ukara is a state where you have already imbibed, you have inscribed, you have understood the gist of the universe, you have understood the gist of the creation. Srishti, Laya, Jati, Gati. You have understood the practical understanding of this creation as to why it had happened and what is the reason and what are the reasons and all. And you start practicing the tantra and mantra aspect in this. The tantra aspects, when I say tantra aspects, you use all kind of rituals there and you apply yourself there. You tend to make yourself accommodative and responsive to the kind of thing by trying to experiment things, and you are trying to, you know, see the reactions of it from the positive point of view. And then once you get the feel of it, that's when you get convinced, and then you start practicing it. And the moment you practice it, the, as we say, mananat trayate iti mantraha, mantra aspect comes into picture. Om is nothing but one mantra that creates that subliminal activity of the human consciousness at various levels. Consciousness, subconsciousness, and super subconsciousness level. And thus it programs the mind. It realigns, it re-engineers, it creates that kind of camouflage. It creates all kinds of reactions in the brain, which may create positive or negative. It is again dependent on the individual. It is again dependent on the Ishvara Srishti's, the way he takes, he or she takes. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. It has practical importance and it has reference to that Ishvara Srishti. Ishvara Srishti and Jiva Srishti. Jiva Srishti is where you tend to create that space by yourself for, you know, with your own interest, experimenting as happens. In the literal sense, one needs to understand this. This is very important for a classical dancer, specifically, be it any kind of dance, all the 8 forms of the dances, even musicians, musicologists, understand this. So that is what happens in Ukara. In Makara, this is the state where you reach to a point wherein you realize yourself. This is a self-realization point. It's like you are getting to understand the difference between real and unreal. And understanding, yes, this is not real, this is unreal, let me go with the literal sense, let me not get attached. Though you get attached with the worldly affairs, you stay detached. Not everyone could achieve this. It was only Ravana Maharshi, Swami Vivekananda, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Sri Sri Bharati Tirthananda Swami Gal. These guys had that ability to balance the act. And this is what is to be understood by an individual. A, U, Ma. Ma is Makara. Makara is a state wherein you are a realized soul. Realized soul means realized soul. Today we tend to see so many babas. That is not the thing. One thinks I am a guru. Everybody are using guru in a literal sense, in a classical dance form. But guru has a very special place. One who understands Ishvara Srishti and Jiva Srishti. If he or she can understand that difference, create that difference, understand between real and unreal, then he gets to the state of Akara, Ukara, and Makara. Auma, Om. Again, the modulation starts. Modulation needs to be understood. Ladies and gentlemen, Om is not a single word. It has to be understood from Akara and Ukara, Akara, Ukara and Makara point of view. And it removes all kinds of negative energies, and it imbibes positive energies, positive vibes in your body. Understand this. Once you understand this Akara, Ukara and Makara aspect of this, you will be able to understand the aspect of Purusha from the intelligence and intellectual essence point of view. That is very important. And Prakriti or the Stri Tattva, Sat plus Trayam, Trilokyam, Mahalakshmi, Mahamai, Mahasaraswati. There are many aspects to this. Omkara Swarupa. Omkara Swarupa has to be taken from a Nirakara point of view. It does not have any form as such. It does not have any form as such. It has just the vibrational magnitudes, the vibrational forces in that. One has to have that. One needs to understand that. Ladies and gentlemen, this is very important. This is very important aspect of classical dance form or the classical music form. Dance does not mean mere entertainment. Dance is all about understanding Akara, Ukara and Makara Tattva. Once you understand this in cross-reference to Ishvara Srishti, then you will understand the Jiva Srishti. And that's when you develop this kind of the positive energy, which will create vibrations in the environment, whereby whole of the universe will get positive energy. And that is the reason why classical dance or the classical music is considered to be divine. If he or she is practicing this diligently, understanding this importance, ladies and gentlemen, things will be very easy. And today we will not have so much apathies what we are having, what we are seeing on this earth. That is, and dance can be taken as a curative measure for all these viruses in the universe that are happening today. However, when it goes beyond a point or beyond a repair point, nothing can be done. And that's when you get to the state of ashes. And this is where the practical importance of Kamadeva's five arrows come into picture when we try to understand it from the point of view of philosophy and spiritual. Ladies and gentlemen, understand this. This is very important aspect. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note and pointers for the individuals, aspiring dancers, scholars, teachers and gurus. Understanding the Omkara Tattva in cross-reference to Jiva Srishti and Ishvara Srishti. Ishvara Srishti again. Understanding it from Akara and Nirakara Sarupa. Thus, taking you to the highest realms of life. Considering the calamities that we are facing, I was thinking of talking about yoga from the point of view of Mama and Rupa, which more or less talks about Ishvara Srishti and Jiva Srishti respectively. However, when we talk about Mama, one needs to understand about Maya and Mahamaya. Even before getting into Rupa, that is Nirakara Swarupa and Akara Swarupa. Now, when we talk about Maya, whatever that we see or whatever that we are tending to think that is real, at this very stage or at this very point in time, one needs to understand that Ishvara Srishti has a typical nature of creating that kind of environment which more or less talks about getting into the aspects before even getting into understanding the exact reality or the exact nature. And in fact, this is what has had happened with the natural calamities that we are facing today. The number of viruses that we have had during our centuries or past years, if I take into consideration starting from anthrax, starting from ozone layer, or you name it, there were many calamities that have had happened during the previous centuries. I remember when I was doing my degree or when I was doing my schooling, I came across various calamities. However, this calamity, which was much expected during that period of time only, but it came at a very right time, better late than never before. One needs to understand Ishvara Srishti has various phases, and if we tend to take the 36 tattvas as granted and try not to think about it, and we act as if it is a Jiva Srishti and we have every right to enjoy it. That does not mean that. That is where the limitations happen. Thus, this is where the Ishvara Srishti is Mama, or wherein he shows all sorts of mayas first and then gets into the Mahamaya, where you will see the happiness in whatever that you are doing. But nobody knows the fact that this is Mahamaya, where you tend to understand, you need to understand this taste for very limited period of time. It has pros and cons. And this is where highest level of intellect happens. Thus, this is where if we are able to discriminate between Maya and Mahamaya and understand Ishvara Swarupa, Ishvara Srishti, Jiva Srishti becomes more easier. And Jiva, or the human existence, when it comes to the earthly being, becomes liberated. And in fact, Bharata's Natya Shastra is all about Maya and Mahamaya. One needs to understand the characterization or the characters that a dancer or the individual enacts. It stays for 1.5 hours time. But one needs to have that guilelessness. One needs to understand, why am I doing that character? And this is where the positive energy or the Shakti, which we talk about, and this is what is called Stri Tattva, Sat plus Trayam. And in case, if you are playing with Stri enactment, you will be doomed. one needs to understand the philosophical and the spiritual aspect of this. And this is where the classical dance or the classical musics or the classical part of body movements, which is what 108 karanas talk about, happens. And this is where the chemical reactions or the reactions in the body start happening. One needs to understand, and this is where Ishwar Srishti's role plays. Ishwara is nothing but, Ishwara Srishti is nothing but Srishti. And getting in laya or getting in sync with that nature, jati, you come in contact and you tend to enjoy, but not in the literal sense. And gati is where, that's the ultimate. If you are trying to understand that gati aspect, either you will turn into ashes, meaning you will get engrossed and forget yourself, or self-realization point, you tend to understand what is real and unreal. And this is where the highest intellectual level starts acting. Thus, this is the practical importance of Ishwara Srishti. And unfortunately, today, we people fail to understand Ishwara Srishti, and we fail to understand Stree's characterization, Stree's Stree as a whole. Sat plus Trayam. Sat means Satvikam. Trayam means Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara Tattva. And it even involves understanding of Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati, Mahamai. Here also Mai. And that is why Stree has such an importance in the Vedic philosophy and Upanishads philosophy. And this we have forgotten for centuries and centuries and centuries. And this is what is the practical understanding of classical dance or the classical music as a whole. For the convenience of the individuals, Bharata may have written in 36 chapters, but bottom line or moral of the story of whole of the dance form, whole of the enactment, or be it kalapam or be it any kind of thing, is to get this brief gist and brief understanding of Jiva Srishti and Ishwara Srishti. However, I will explain Ishwara Srishti in my next video. In this video, I am just trying to explain you the Ishwara Srishti. Most of us think Ishwara Srishti, Ishwara means having those jada jutas, or having that snake and Damaruka and Trishula. Trishula is again Triloka. It interprets Triloka. Snake represents, you have various calamities, but still you need to stay balanced. And this is what is the Ishvara Tattva. Damaruka here means you get sound out of it from Damaruka. The kind of sound you get is so disturbance that it disturbs you from various angles. But still, you need to stay balanced in this world called Maya world and Mahamaya world. Once we get to that Maya and Mahamaya state, take control over Maya and Mahamaya, that's the highest plane, which not everyone can get to that state. Very few can get to that. One needs to have the proper understanding of Ishvara Srishti. Today, for whatever calamities that are happening, I would say from the philosophical or the spiritual approach, we fail to understand Ishvara Tattva or Ishvara Srishti from the 36 Tattvas point of view. We took them as granted. We never tried to understand to the deeper aspect, to the depth aspect of it. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note and pointers for the individuals who are watching my videos to understand Ishvara Srishti and Jiva Srishti when he or she is learning yoga therapy, or he or she is trying to practice yoga or meditational practices. Once we are understanding this, believe me, any kind of virus in this universe will not affect us, because you are trying to understand between real and unreal. You are limiting yourself. Our mind is the biggest troublemonger, biggest troublemaker. We are not putting positive thoughts into that. That is also one reason why you get viruses. Ladies and gentlemen, understand this in the deeper and depth aspect. Now let's take the subject much further from the Manduka Upanishad. Mandukyam ekameva alam mumukshunam vimukhyate. What does that mean? For the seeker, the Mandukya alone is enough. If we are able to understand the true meaning or this single Upanishad, there is no need to learn any other Upanishads. Chandogya or Brihadaranyaka is also not necessary, as this has direct approach to the depths of the human nature. It states bare facts in reality with respect to man in general and reality in its essential character. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. Such a beautiful Mandukyam ekameva alam mumukshunam vimukhyate. It's like, you know, to understand human science or the human nature, Patanjali was talking about Kriya Yoga, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, various stages. However, here directly, if we understand, Patanjali understood this very, very line and explained this Mandukya Upanishad. In simple terms, and one needs to understand, as this has direct approach to the depths of the human nature, what really direct depths to the human nature means over here, and why it is talking about, like, it states bare facts in reality with respect of man in general and reality in its essential character. Now, whole of this concept, if you really see, Patanjali explained in step-by-step process. Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga. In Karma Yoga, he again talks about Kriya Yoga. And Kriya Yoga is based on the concept of Panchakoshas again. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. Such a beauty of our Vedas and Upanishads. This is the beauty of Vedas and Upanishads. And in fact, this is being used, or this is being practiced in classical dance or the dance form. And this is being used in the music as well. It could be Mohiniyattam, it could be Bharatanatyam, it could be Kuchipudi, it could be any kind of dance. I'm talking in generic sense. This is the practical application of Upanishads. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the biggest challenge for anyone to understand. One needs to understand the practical importance of Upanishads and Vedas. Why we are talking about human consciousness there? Here also he is talking, the Mandukya Upanishad talks about the human consciousness as a whole, as a single entity. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. That is the reason why dance is considered to be divine and music is also considered to be divine at first place. It has its own divinity. And that is the reason why it is a Gupta Jnana as well. And this is what is called Sri Vidya. And this is where actually, like, even it talks about Ishvara Srishti and Jiva Srishti, which I will be talking in my next video. Jiva Srishti is all about, like, combating the situations and culminating all your thoughts and creating that image. Ishvara Srishti is nothing but whatever that is in nature. That is what is called Srishti, Laya, Jati and Gati. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. There is always this line. And this is one very important point and one important aspect in classical dance form when it comes to Bharata's Natya Shastra as such. One needs to have a wider and vivid understanding of the subject. And this is the beauty of Natya Shastra, by the by. If one understands this to the deep or to the depth, dance becomes more easier and dancer can get to the highest spiritual realm. That is the seventh phase to the Ajna Chakra. Thus I conclude this video with a positive note and the pointers for the dancers as an individual to understand, not only dancers, individuals, musicologists, medical professionals, and scientists, and scholars in the philosophy. It's an open-ended question, a debatable question as well, that Upanishads have direct relation to dance and music as such, as a whole. And if we are talking about Srishti, it is Ishvara Srishti and Jeeva Srishti. That's what it's all about. Thus I conclude this. Purusha. Why? Purusha is very much necessary when he or she is practicing yoga or a meditation practitioner. Who is this Purusha? Is Purusha gender based? One needs to have. In this video, let me try explaining you what is the concept of Purusha as per human consciousness or human existence, respectively. We talk about Prakriti and Purusha. We talk about Shakta and Shakti, Shiva and Parvati. Is Purusha considered to be Shiva, Vishnu, Brahma? Let's try analyzing this. Because today in this video, the pointers for the individuals, scholars, aspiring dancers, musicians, musicologists, yoga practitioners, one needs to understand the Purusha aspect. It's very much important. Why Purusha? The point is, here Purusha means he could be stree or any gender for that matter. He is gender variant. By default, every human being who comes on this earth comes with two aspects, male and female. However, one needs to understand, female does not mean having those breasts or other activities wherein it has motherhood or prema, showing that motherly touch towards the kids. It is there even with the males. So Purusha here means developing a kind of attitude, positive attitude towards the society. It's like safeguarding. When I say safeguarding, with certain limitations, certain limits, and acting accordingly. It is for us to decide as to what are your boundaries. However, Purusha here does not mean he could be he
or even she. Today, if we see the kind of atrocities that are happening, or the kind of activities which are against the nature, we are not trying to understand the practical aspects of the Purusha as such, respectively, and true definition of Stri, Sat plus Trayam. The point is, one needs to have a broader and vivid understanding about Purusha. He has various responsibilities. Purusha as a single entity has various responsibilities bound with selflessness, guilelessness, that caring attitude, helping nature, etc. However, what is this Virata Rupa? Virata Rupa again is like there are quite a few functionalities when we talk about Purusha as a single entity. Virat means having that command, having taking that responsibility, taking that dignity, taking that dignity, making yourself accustomed to that kind of environment, trying to help others, trying to make sure you show that Vatsalya Bhavana, you take the due care. When I say due care, you take that additional care or the preventive steps. Let's say there are certain there are certain things which happen to you which may harm you or your kid or anyone for that matter in the society. That heroism or whatever it is, heroism does not mean being showing yourself as fighting or whatever it is. Heroism here means it a different aspect altogether. So one needs to have the clarity of understanding the true meaning of Purusha. It has a very wider meaning. Thus, Virata Purusha, understanding of the Virata Purusha and true definition of Virata Purusha is also important when he or she is looking at yoga, which involves controlling of certain emotions. Where to be controlled, where to act. Thus, Purusha's enactment has the key role. However, the pointers from this video are understanding the true meaning of Virata Purusha from the perspective of human sciences. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Have a nice day ahead. Furthermore, wherein I was talking about yoga and its importance, I was talking about kleshas. However, one needs to have that understanding in detail and in depth into deeper aspects. Why should one understand kleshas? Kleshas here means your inner emotions, your habits, whatnot, everything in a more positive way. Let's try to get into the subject in detail. As Patanjali states, the sadhaka should undergo the Kriya Yoga discipline to acquire the necessary knowledge and for the weakening of the powerful grip of the kleshas like avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesa upon his being, his or her being as an individual. These kleshas are the root causes for his or her sufferings and bondages. However, there are vitarkas and vikshepas as well. However, this subject will be dealt in detail in my coming videos. First, why is he talking about the undergoing of Kriya Yoga? Is the point or is the question one needs to ask for himself or herself? Because when you start practicing yoga or when you start meditating on yourself, one needs to have the proper understanding of the existence and coexistence of human being as a single entity, because he or she comes with the zero quantity in his or her brain. Though the functionalities will be there by default in right and left corner, right and left side of the brain, without any kind of knowledge, once he or she comes to the earth or takes birth and starts his or her journey, he needs to understand the basic importance. And there has to be a discipline, there has to be a structure, there has to be a schematic thought process to give it a full circle. However, today, Darth is a situation that parents do not have time for children, as it is a rat race. Everybody are thinking of how do I to earn money, but they are not having enough time to think about themselves or anyone as a whole. So the primal responsibility of a parent is to make sure he or she first practices, specifically women or mother or stri. Ivala talli tandrulki time ledu. Yedunna pargettodo pargo 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 pargo. ఈ సమస్య ఆ సమస్య ఎన్ని సమస్యలు వచ్చినా ఏ సమస్య వచ్చినా తనకు తాను తెలుసుకోలేకపోతున్నాడు. అది అనాదిగా వస్తున్నది. ఒక సివిలైజేషన్ అవనీయండి, ఒక సొసైటీ పరంగా అవనీయండి, ఏదో రకమైన ఒత్తిడి, దానివల్ల పిల్లలకి పట్టించుకోవడం మానేస్తున్నారు, వదిలేస్తున్నారు, అర్థం చేసుకోవటం లేదు. యోగం యొక్క సారం ఈ మాయా మహామాయ గురించి తెలుసుకోవడమే. ఎప్పుడైతే ఒక తల్లి కానీ, ఒక స్త్రీ కానీ, ఒక అమ్మ కానీ ఆలోచిస్తుందో ఇలాగ చిన్నప్పటి నుంచి, అది తను పుట్టబోయే బిడ్డ ఏదైతే వస్తుందో, పరాసర్ప ఒక సెక్షువల్ ఇంటర్కోర్స్ వల్ల జెనెటికల్గా, అదే ఒక కొడుకు కానీ కూతురు కానీ వస్తుంది, అదే ఆలోచించే విధానం వస్తుంది. అది మనం తెలుసుకోవాల్సింది ఇక్కడ. అదే ఒక సారం. అది దానికి ప్రత్యక్ష సాక్ష్యం అభిమన్యుడు. అభిమన్యుడు గర్భంలో ఉంటూ ఉండగానే చక్రవ్యూహంలో ఎలా వెళ్ళాలి అనేది తెలుసుకున్నాడు, మొత్తం అన్నీ తెలుసుకున్నాడు, కానీ బయటికి రావడం తెలుసుకోలేకపోయాడు. అది తర్వాత విషయం. కానీ దీంట్లో మనం ఇక్కడ సారం తెలుసుకోవాల్సింది ఏంటంటే, ఒక కొడుకు కానీ కూతురు కానీ, ఒక బిడ్డ తల్లి గర్భంలో ఉంటూ ఉండగా వింటూ ఉంటాడు, అవే మనకి జెనెటికల్గా వస్తూ ఉంటాయి. See, the practical example for this is in Mahabharata. Abhimanyu, when Abhimanyu was in the mother's womb, he could hear how to get into Chakravyuh. However, let's not get into why he could not come out and why he could not. This is where the practical example of mother's practices as responsibility happens. He or she, she has to understand that she is the caretaker of the child inside her womb, who will be for 9 months understanding whole of the structure and scheme of living or ideologies. Whole of the ideas start get into the child's brain initially. However, when he or she comes out from the mother's womb, that's when he starts exploring. Initially, between 0 and 5th year, it will be like he won't be able to understand. He will be just seeing things in and around, but still, whatever thoughts that mother had will be instilled and imbibed in his or her mind. After 5th year itself, he or she starts understanding. And this is where the genetical and hereditary kind of thing starts developing. However, as I was speaking about Kriya Yoga in my previous video, Kriya Yoga has to have some sort of discipline, scheme and structure. So that is the reason why Patanjali emphasizes on having discipline and clear structure and clear scheme for the same. Why? In order to make sure that you weaken the powerful grip of the kleshas. Kleshas are nothing but the habits or the shortcomings. Shortcomings are avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha. Ikkada kleshalante emi kaadu. Kleshalante avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha. ఇవన్నీ తెలుసుకోవాలంటే మనిషి యొక్క క్రమక్రమంగా తెలుస్తూ ఉంటుంది. అది చేయాలి అంటే మనం ఒక పద్ధతి అనేది పాటించాలి. దాన్నే మనం డిసిప్లిన్ అంటాం, ఒక స్ట్రక్చర్ అంటాం, ఒక స్కీమ్ అంటాం. అదే మనిషికి కానీ, ఒక స్త్రీ కానీ పురుషుడికి కానీ అలవాటు అవుతుంది క్రమక్రమేణా పెద్ద అవుతున్న కొద్ది. చెప్పాలంటే, ఇంకా చెప్పాలంటే, ఇది చేయడం వల్ల ఒక మనిషికి తనకు తాను తెలుసుకోవడానికి అవకాశం ఉంటుంది. ఇది ఎప్పుడైతే డిసిప్లిన్డ్గా లేదో, ఇది ఎప్పుడైతే మనకి ఒక స్ట్రక్చర్గా లేదో, ఒక స్కీమ్గా లేదో, అది ఏం చేస్తుందంటే మనకి ఏదో ఏదో రకమైన కష్టం, ఏదో రకమైన అన్నమాట, అక్కడ ఏదో రకంగా బాధపడతాడు మనిషి. ఎప్పుడైతే తెలుసుకుంటాడో తనకు తాను, ఇంకా తనకి కష్టాలే ఉండవు. ద మూమెంట్ హీ ఆర్ షీ ట్రైస్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ దీస్ క్లేషస్ లైక్ అవిద్య, అస్మిత, రాగ, ద్వేష, అభినివేశ, he or she will not have that feeling that, you know, these sufferings and why this bondage, why these sufferings, etc.
Highest realms of the state of the mind. Thus, I conclude with a positive.